Okay, everybody. So we're gonna talk a bit about Gleevac's departure from console and switching to PC. I actually got together my team, Team Reflect, to share their own thoughts on that. So why don't we start with some introductions? Let's start with Wodka.
Hey guys, I'm Dr. Wodka. I'm the Lucio Zenyatta Mercy when we do pharmacy. Hi.
Strat.
Hi, I'm Sharjan. I play main tank on Team Reflect.
Nice. Toad?
He muted his mic, so.
Remember. He can still introduce himself.
Hello, I'm a spooky toad. I'm the off tank player. I play Winston and Zarya.
RLA.
I am RLA. I play DPS for Team Reflect and mainly McCree, Soldier, Tracer, hitscan characters.
Neon.
Sometimes Widow.
I'm Neon and I play basically the Anna for the team.
Yami.
That's it.
Oh wait, what? It's my turn? Oh, hi. My name's Yami. I'm the sub for Team Reflect. I play DPS, Tracer, Soldier, and Bastion.
Mainly Bastion, let's be real.
Yeah, exactly. A good emphasis on Bastion.
And lastly, Baraka.
Team Reflect manager.
Oh, he's so quiet.
Good intro,
first
good
time.
Intro.
So, big deal for the console community. I mean, there's not many console YouTubers out there. Most of them are just like titled most toxic player and then that's their video and then they always end up being on console. So there really isn't that many. Gleevac was one of the higher ups. It's actually like his identity. So, Wodka, what are your quick thoughts on the switch to PC?
He's definitely doing well on PC, I've noticed. He was a major influence to the console community, at least he was one of the main people I've noticed on YouTube who are from console. And, I don't know, him leaving is just a huge blow to people on console.
Yeah.
Like, there's not as many videos going to come out for us.
Right, yeah, they're not going to be catered to us. This part, this is kind of like an open discussion, guys, so, you know, if you got something to say, go ahead.
Oh, well, I don't know. I remember watching, like, one of his videos, like, a while back, back when I pretty much was in the mindset that if we had a Widow on our team, it basically meant we lost. Although she has received some buffs now, so she's not... I even run her sometimes in comp, and she's not nearly as unviable as I thought she was back then. I think, honestly, like, him moving to PC will probably be beneficial to him as long as he can maintain the high level of an entertaining gameplay that he's been putting up on console. Mainly because I think he can actually climb higher in ranked on PC than he could on console, because on console, like, as much as, like, I've played against him before and a lot of other, like, really high-tier Widowmaker players on console, and their one issue, I find, is that if they can't play other heroes, they kind of get stuck in the situation where she's not viable all the time. And that even can apply for PC, but for PC you can get away with it more because the aiming is so much more
right.
Fine-tuned, and it's a lot easier to make a bigger impact. So I think that the Widow console players... Just in general, there's a lack of consistency. Like sometimes they'll do amazing. You're like, oh crap, that's a really good Widowmaker, right? But then sometimes it's just you'll have like just missing shots, and at that point you probably need to switch, or you're not really gonna benefit. Like the one time I played him in comp, the second point it's attack, he was still on the Widow, and it just wasn't getting as many picks to make her as a viable character with the respawn of our defense
right.
being so close. And that's where I think that she just kind of loses a lot of her viability, but I think that he'll probably be able to climb higher with her just for the fact that PC, she still maintains a little bit more viability if you're good enough with her, and I think that he can be good enough with her
yeah,
to make that work. So I think, honestly, for his channel, it's probably going to be beneficial, because I think he kind of reached a point on console where he kind of got stuck in the rank that he was right around, like right around Masters or lower Masters or Diamond, High Diamond, that kind of area.
Right. I think is what and I. And a few of the videos that he's mainly. Posted up already and, on PC, he's transitioning very well. He's very good.
Definitely. That's one thing I'm not, like, I don't know if he has any other PC game background.
Yeah, I don't know about that either.
I don't, and that's why when I tried, that's why I know that when I tried going to PC, it was a lot harder for me. I'm nowhere near as good aiming on PC than I am on console, just because I'm just used to playing on console. But, I mean, maybe he has some other background with other, like, CSGO or, like, some other shooter game on PC before, so he might be not as rough as a transition. But I think, honestly, I think his channel will just still do well. I think he has a big following, even that will still watch him, whatever thing he's playing on console or PC. Mm-hmm. So, I think he'll still do well. I hope that every once in a while he'll come back to console and just like.
Yeah, he hasn't commented on sure, that like, if he's going to come back periodically, but I'm pretty sure he's staying on PC for good. I'm pretty sure that was said.
Yeah, yeah.
Stratigan, did you see like the video or anything?
I mean,
I haven't checked out his latest videos, but honestly though, if he moves to PC, it makes a lot of sense because it's on to the bare bones actually shooter game. You want to have the ability to maximize your skills. So if he thinks that he can switch to mouse and keyboard, and then he's gonna, it's gonna make him a better player, then by all means, I mean like by to the bare bone is essentially a shooter. But although it's even though it's a shooter, but for some heroes, it's a bit different. Like for example, heroes that don't necessarily need a lot of aim, like Winston and Reinhardt. Like switching to PC won't make a lot of difference. It comes down to game sense. Like for me, I play on PC as well, on the side here and there. But mostly I just play on PS4. There's no difference whatsoever for me as a job as playing a tank. But for him, it's gonna be advantageous for him. But for me, it's just the same thing. It can't, because I'm as playing heroes that are reliant to my teammates, Reinhardt and Zarya. It comes down to game sense instead of just accuracy. You know.
What I wonder is if he's going to take on more of the streamer, or like where he's trying to go with his channel, I wonder. Like, I know he does a lot of the Widowmaker things, but is he going to become maybe more of like a big streamer on PC, or is he want to even try to get into like the like competitive scene on there, or what's he really going to do? I mean, I just think it's going to be interesting to see where he takes his channel from here. Because I know for a while, like, he was in a niche where like he was one of the only really console Widowmakers who posted really good gameplay. And probably one of the best console winmakers in general, as it is. I wonder where he's going to kind of move it. What is going to move his content toward? I assume he'll still be playing a lot of Widowmaker, but whether he's moving it more toward being like a streamer or being more in the post scene or just playing in general, doing what he's been doing.
I know I'm Yami really sure. wants to be so, the.
But I think it'd be interesting to see.
What'd you call it, Yami? The budget Widowmaker?
I'm going to be a budget Gleevac.
Oh, the budget Gleevac?
I'm going to be the budget Gleevac. I'm going to be the budget Gleevac on Hanzo.
So what are your...
I don't think more like a budget Seagull.
What are your thoughts on it, Yami?
Well, my thoughts on it, I honestly do believe that he has a PC background. Like, coming me personally, I play Overwatch on PC. But, like, one of my bigger games that I play on PC is CSGO. Like, I'm a global elite in CSGO, and I still play it to this day.
Nice.
He's doing really well for someone who just transitioned to PC. But it's gonna put a dent in the console community for sure, just because, like... When you see a video on console people, you just sort of see, like, toxicity.
Right, they're all videos of just most toxic player, and I'm like, oh yeah, these are fun, and then I'll click on it, and it's a console gameplay. And that's pretty much all there is.
And then you also have PC... Then you also have PC players defining console players just by saying that if they are heavily skilled, then it's just all aim assist. But when you have someone like Gleevac, who's already proven to a good majority of the PC player, PC player base that he is really good, but this could also end up something good for the console community, because you have people like DSP Stanky, because he originally started out on YouTube. PC players were like, there's no way he's this good on Lucio. It's just all aim assist. He switched to PC, he's very right. Well known now. So, I think it's gonna put a dent and a buff here and there. I don't know how to explain it, but it's just something right there. It's gonna happen. Something's gonna happen.
Baraka, do you have any opinions on this? I don't know if he's on mute.
Alright, well. That's alright. I don't know,
I think there were a lot of people that looked up to Gleevac on console. But I think since he has such a big following for his channel, I think they'll just convert right over to PC, even though he's not on PS4 anymore, because they just like the way he does things on Widow, and his plays are amazing. So I think him switching to PC isn't really going to be a big change for his fans. It might be a big change for him, just because he hasn't really, I don't think, played on PC before, and if he has, not for like a very long time, like he's going to be doing now. So that's right. My thoughts on it.
Neon, how about you? Do you have any thoughts?
I say it's a good change, because sooner or later we're all going to have to join the PC Master Race and really start enjoying more games and better games, really, because on PC for Overwatch, I suppose it's a lot better because you have a lot more people. You're not constantly running into the same people, like you said, how he's in like the Masters and High Diamonds range. You're just going to keep playing against the same people, but once you like get on PC, you have like way more people. I know like on PS4 there's only like 100,000 people who play, and that gets kind of boring playing against the same people over right. and over again.
But I hear it's a similar issue on PC as well. Maybe not as often, but I hear it happens as well.
I think it's more about the rank yeah. system, that there's not many
yeah, it's
people
Grand
up
Masters,
there.
Yeah, top 500, you're going to bump into each other.
Yeah. I think
Like, the thing is, like, I heard talking about toxic people on console, but then you have hackers on PC. People who have aim assist, and that's a lot more likely
right.
than on console. I'd rather have toxic people than
right.
cheaters. Toxic, you can fix by mute. Hacking, you can't.
Hey, I respect Gleevac. At least he's not just, like, getting a master keyword adapter for a console.
Yeah. Toad, I know you don't. You're not familiar with Gleevac, but.
Yeah.
Do you have any opinions?
I don't know much about Gleevac. I know that he doesn't like spaghetti. He says moist a lot. Also know that he's a pretty good Widow on console. And I feel the console community is kind of neglected as much as it is. Because you know when they're talking and when the big YouTubers are talking about Overwatch, they're talking about PC. Right. And they'll, like, occasionally in an offhand they'll say, oh, and console, you know, blah, blah, blah. But I think it's probably not good, but we still, I guess it makes room for more console YouTubers. That can't hurt.
Right.
I mean, I know you're a console YouTuber, so
that I
you'll get more attention. That can hurt.
I'm actually proud of it. So I have a couple thoughts about it. It is a risk. It is a risk. Gleevac built his entire channel based around that he was the top Widowmaker on console. And that was a huge draw, because I believe there is a healthy, hungry console community that is just heavily, heavily neglected. And his entire identity was built on that. So switching over to PC, he's going to lose some of that identity for sure. From his new gameplay, it seems like his skill is up there enough to where he may still hold on to most of that identity, and you know, people will be talking about Kepri versus Gleevac, you know, we could have those discussions. And I read a lot of the comments when he announced his Switch, and I've read both, you know, I've read people that feel they've been betrayed because that's what they came to his channel for. And I've heard people who are all for it and say, hey, I mean, we're all going to switch eventually, right? And some of his fans are even from PC. So they're definitely in favor of the Switch. It's a huge risk because he runs the risk of blending in with every other good widow that has a YouTube channel on PC. On console, he pretty much had a monopoly on it. Not only is console just neglected anyways, but he was a Widowmaker main. So, yeah, he kind of had a monopoly on it, and he definitely helped my channel grow. I mean, he saw the potential of my channel. He helped me out. Wodka came from one of his videos, and now she's on Team Reflect. So, it's a huge hit. It's a huge hit, just because there's just a really hungry community out there. I don't have any plans whatsoever on switching because I'm terrible at mouse and keyboard. I really am. I've tried here and there over the years, and I just can't do it. Same. But I do hope it works out for him. I hope that he can keep building his channel and building his identity as, you know, the top widow, despite all the other good widows on PC. So, any last thoughts?
Good luck to him, I guess.
I hope he eventually, you know, likes spaghetti. I don't know anyone who doesn't like spaghetti. Still hasn't answered me, so if Gleevac, you're watching this, you gotta answer. Do you like spaghetti?
Do you like spaghetti?
If you're watching this, I'm stealing the place.
We must know.
Gleevac, if you're watching this, I'm taking the place.
As the budget Gleevac.
Very important.
And also I want to know if you like spaghetti too, because I love spaghetti, okay?
We gotta know if Yami has to like spaghetti or not.
Yeah. Like, tell me your favorite food in a comment, that way I can just eat it and become you. It's okay, I'll take your place. It's
well,
fine.
Go ahead.
Another thing is that I got another question though on the side, since we're talking about Gleevac moving to console. How many YouTube Overwatch that's actually playing on console only? How many? Is it like you, Gleevac?
You mean other than the most toxic player videos? There is a channel.
Little T500. Okay.
The one that's actually dedicated only on
he
console.
He is a Widowmaker player on console. If you look at, he is pretty toxic though. If you look at Gleevac's videos, every once in a while you'll see one comment that's just like, "Oh, Little T's better." there's at least one in every video, I swear. but he doesn't have as big of a following, just because honestly, I think the he's just kind of annoying. I played against him in comp, and he doesn't run Widowmaker all the time. That's why I think he's climbed higher ranked than Gleevac is, because Gleevac was strictly Widowmaker, you know? And he doesn't run only Widowmaker, he runs other characters too. But honestly, the guy, when I was watching him, seemed really toxic and kind of annoying. So that's why I think his channel hasn't grown as much as Gleevac's did. Gleevac seems pretty humble and just like a general nicer guy. And,
I know there's another channel known as Omega. He's got about like 70,000 subs, and he's on console. I don't really see too much console-specific things on his channel, but in terms of YouTubers who represent console, he's definitely probably the biggest one I've seen so far. So, but yeah, literally, we can count on one hand how many representatives for console are on Overwatch and YouTube.
All right, hold on. I got my fingers out right now. Hold up. Okay, so we have Chit Chat. We have known as Omega, Toxic Videos,
Little I don't think T, that counts.
Yeah, this is, so yeah, there's not I that many. So,
because my concern is, one more thought, because my concern is, since so many people are playing on PC now instead of console, a lot of people are going to thought like, hey, these famous YouTubers are playing on PC, why should I play on console? Why not move to PC? Because my argument would be, I think the number one factor on when deciding should you play on PC or console is probably just play where your friends are. If your friends are on console, then by all means play on console. If your friends are on PC, play on PC.
because the game is going to be so much dull if you don't know anyone on that specific platform. Yeah, so I'm just trying to, get that into people's minds.
It's great to do that, like, just to play with your friends, because, you know, the game is for fun.
I also think just, like, play what you like to play on more. Like, I find playing on console more fun in general. Like, I've just always played on console. I never really got into the PC scene. It just, the playing with a controller
I agree with my
me a controller pleb, but, like, I don't know. It's just, like,
I agree with RLA, even though, like, I play CSGO a lot. That's one of the, like, CSGO and TF2 are, like, a few of my PC shooters.
Right.
But I was definitely raised on a controller because, you know, you got Halo. Halo was dope. Because that was, like, my first first-person shooter on Xbox.
So,
Yeah, controllers.
So, any last thoughts, and then we can wrap it up?
I think that's pretty good.
Yeah, that's
done for me.
All right.
Good luck.
So, that was the discussion from Team Reflect on Gleevac's switch to PC and leaving console behind. We all wish him lots of luck and hope he continues to grow. And I'm going to do my little outro that I always do live. That's it for today, guys. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to share it, like, and subscribe to the channel. My name is Chit, and I approve this message.
Leave out, do you like spaghetti?